Following list of contents have been discussed as contamination of heavy metals, mass balance of heavy metals in the soil, as how heavy metals contribute into the soil by application of pesticide, fertilizers, use of biosolids, manure, metal mining, mineral, industrial waste, also a source of heavy metals contamination in the soil. Airborne sources also include contamination via the food chain, as heavy metals bioaccumulate and biomagnify. Regulatory guidelines, soil contamination by heavy metals is of most importance throughout the industrialized world. Heavy metal pollution not only result in adverse effects on various parameters relating to plant quality and yield, but also cause changes in size, composition, activity of the microbial community. Heavy metals are considered as one of the most source of soil pollution. Heavy metal pollution of the soil is caused by various metals, especially copper, nickel, cadmium, zinc, chromium and lead. The adverse effects of heavy metals on soil biological and biochemical properties are well documented. The soil properties, that is organic matter, clay contents and pH, have major influence on the extent of effects of metal. Heavy metals indirectly affect soil enzymatic activities by shifting the microbial community which synthesizes enzymes. Heavy metals exhibit toxic effects towards soil biota by affecting key microbial process and decrease the number and activity of soil microorganisms. Long-term heavy metal effects can increase bacterial community tolerance as well as the tolerance of fungi such as arbuscular mycorrhizal fungi, which can play an important role in the restoration of contaminated ecosystem. Soil may become contaminated by the accumulation of heavy metals and metallites through emissions from rapidly expanding industrial areas, mine tailings, disposal of high metal waste, leaded gasoline, paints, land application of fertilizers, animal manure, sewage sludge, pesticides, wastewater irrigation, coal combustion residues, spillage of petrochemicals, atmospheric deposition. Heavy metals constitute an ill-defined group of inorganic chemical hazards and those most commonly found at contaminated sites are include lead, chromium, arsenic, zinc, cadmium, copper, mercury, nickel. Soil are the major sink for heavy metals released into the environment by aforementioned anthropogenic activities, and unlike organic contaminants which are oxidized to carbon oxide by microbial action, most metals don't undergo microbial or chemical degradation, and their total concentration in soil persists for a long time after their introduction. Changes in their chemical form, saturation and bioavailability are, however, possible. The presence of toxic metals in the soil can inhibit the biodegradation of organic contaminants. Heavy metal contamination of soil may pose risks and hazards to humans and ecosystem through direct injection or contact with contaminated soil, the food chain, as soil plant human or soil plant animal human. through the food chain, transfer of heavy metal as from the soil to plant and plant to the human, or soil to plant and plant to the animal and then to the human. Drinking of contaminated groundwater, reduction in food quality, safety and marketability via phytotoxicity, reduction in land usability for agricultural production, causing food insecurity and land tenure problems. Heavy metals occur naturally in the soil environment from pedogenetic processes of weathering of parent materials at levels that are regarded as traces as and really toxic. Due to disturbance and acceleration of nature slowly occurring geochemical cycle of metals by man, most soils of rural and urban environments may accumulate one or more of heavy metals above defined background values, high enough to causal risk to human health, plants, animals, ecosystem or other media. The heavy metals essentially become contaminants in the soil environment because their rates of generation via man-made cycles are more rapid relative to the natural one. They become transferred from mine to random environmental locations where higher potential of direct exposure occur. The concentration of metals in discarded products are relatively high compared to those in receiving environment. Chemical form in which metal is found in receiving environment system may render it more bioavailable. A simple mass balance of the heavy metal in the soil can be expressed as follow: M total is equal to MP, M plus MA, MF, where these abbreviations as M is the heavy metal and P is the parent material, A is in the equation is the atmospheric deposition, F is the from the fertilizer sources, AG are the agriculture sources, OW represents the organic waste sources, IP represent the inorganic pollutants, and CR which is the crop removal, and L is the losses by leaching, volatilization and so forth. It is projected that anthropogenic emission into the atmosphere for several heavy metals is 1 to 3 orders of magnitude higher than natural fluxes. Historically, agriculture was the first major human intensive on the soil. To grow and complete the life cycle, plants must acquire not only macronutrients, that macronutrients include nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, sulfur, calcium and magnesium, but also require essential micronutrients. Some soils are deficient into heavy metals such as cobalt, copper, iron, manganese, nickel, zinc, that are essential for healthy plant growth, and crops may be supplied with these as in addition to the soil as foliar supplement. Cereal crops grown on copper deficient soils are occasionally treated with copper as an addition to the soil, and manganese may similarly supply to the cereal and root crops. Large quantities of fertilizers are regularly added to the soil in intensive farming systems to provide adequate nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium for crop growth. The compounds used to supply these elements contain trace amount of heavy metals, for example cadmium and lead, as impurities in these metals, which after continued application of fertilizer may increase their content in the soil. Metals such as cadmium and lead have no physiological activity. Application of certain phosphate fertilizer inadequately inadvertently adds cadmium and other potentially toxic elements to the soil, including fluorine, mercury and lead. These fertilizers are sprayed on the crops to increase the yield and for increase the crop production and supply the essential nutrients to the crop. Phosphate fertilizers are produced from the phosphate rock by acidulation. In acidulation of single superphosphate, sulfuric acid is used, while in acidulation of triple superphosphate, phosphoric acid is used. The final product contains all of the heavy metals present as constituents in the phosphate rock. Commercial inorganic fertilizers, particularly phosphate fertilizers, can potentially contribute to the global transport of heavy metals. Heavy metals added to the agricultural soil through inorganic fertilizers may leach into the groundwater and contaminate it. Phosphate fertilizers rich in toxic heavy metals also contaminate the soil and water. Two main pathways for the transfer of heavy metals from phosphate fertilizers to human body are shown below. Phosphate fertilizers originate from the phosphate rock, as they include sulfuric acid and phosphoric acid is used in the phosphate fertilizers. Their contamination into the soil. After contamination into the soil, when this is used for the crop production, contamination into the soil, plants come into the plants, and from the plant enter into the food of the human body via the food chain transfer to the human. And other phosphate type of phosphate fertilizers that contaminate the water bodies, and through the water bodies they contaminate the human body. Several common pesticides are used in agriculture and horticulture in the past contained substantial concentration of metals. As all of us aware that pesticides are used to increase the crop yield and production, and pesticides include herbicides, fungicides, rodenticides, molluscicides, bactericides to kill the insects and weeds. Different types of pesticides are used for different purposes. It depends that what type of insects that contaminate the crop. For instance, in the recent past, about 10% of the chemical was approved for use as an insecticide and fungicide in UK were based on the compounds which contain copper, mercury, manganese, lead and zinc. Examples of such pesticides are copper containing fungicidal sprays such as Bordeaux mixture which contain copper sulfate and copper oxychloride. Lead arsenate was used in the fruit orchards for many years to control some parasitic insects. Now the arsenic containing compounds were also used for extensively to control cattle, ticks, and do control pests in banana in New Zealand and Australia. Timbers have been preserved with formulation of copper, chromium and arsenic. And there are no many sites where soil concentration of these elements exceeds background concentration. Such contamination has the potential to cause problem, particularly if sites are redeveloped for other agricultural or non-agricultural purposes. Compared with the fertilizers, the use of such material has been more localized, being restricted to particular sites or crops. Now the application of numerous biosolids, for example livestock manure, compost, municipal sewage sludge to land, leads to the accumulation of heavy metals such as arsenic, cadmium, chromium, copper, lead, mercury, nickel, selenium, molybdenum, zinc in the soil. Certain animals waste such as poultry, cattle, pig manure produced in agriculture are commonly applied to the crops and pastures either as a solid or slurry. Also, most manures are seen as valuable fertilizers in the pig and poultry industry. The copper and zinc added to the diet as growth promoters and arsenic contained in the poultry health products may also have potential to cause metal contamination of the soil. The manure produced from animals on such diets contain high concentration of arsenic, copper and zinc, and if applied to the restricted areas of land can cause buildup of these metals in the soil in the long run. Biosolids, sewage sludge are primarily organic solid products produced by the wastewater treatment process. Land application of biosolid material is common practice in many countries that allow the reuse of biosolids produced by urban population. The term solid sewage sludge is used in many references because of its wide recognition and its regulatory definition. Biosolid is more common as a replacement for sewage sludge. It is estimated that in United States, more than half of approximately 5.6 million dry tons of sewage sludge used or disposed of annually is land applied. And agricultural utilization of biosolids occurs in every region of the country. In European Community, 30% of the sewage sludge is used as a fertilizer in agriculture. There is also a considerable interest in potential for composting biosolids with other organic materials such as sawdust, straw, garden waste. If this trend continues, there will be implications for the metal contamination of soil. The potential of biosolids for contaminating soils with heavy metals has caused great concern about their application in agricultural practices. Heavy metals most commonly found in biosolids are lead, nickel, cadmium, chromium, copper, and nature of the intensity of the industrial activity as well as the type of process implied during the biosolids treatment. Under certain conditions, metals added to the soil in application of biosolids can be leached downward through the soil profile and can have the potential to contaminate groundwater. Recent studies on some New Zealand and soils treated with biosolids have shown increased concentration of cadmium, nickel and zinc in drainage leachate during mining, tailing heavier and larger particles that settled at the bottom of flotation cell during mining is known as tailing, are directly discharged into natural depressions including on-site wetlands, resulting in elevated concentration. Extensive lead and zinc ore mining and smelting have resulted in contamination of soil that poses risk to human and ecological health. Many reclamation methods used for these sites are lengthy and expensive and may not restore soil productivity. Soil heavy metal environmental risk to humans is related to bioavailability. Assimilation pathways include the ingestion of plant growth in food chain or direct injection, that is the oral bioavailability of contaminated soil. Other materials are generated by a variety of industries such as textile, tanning, petrochemicals, from accidental oil spills or utilization of petroleum-based products, pesticides, pharmaceutical facilities, and few have benefits of agriculture or forestry. In addition, many are potentially hazardous because of their contents of heavy metals, chromium, lead and zinc or toxic organic compounds and are seldom. If ever applied to land, others are very low in plant nutrients or have no soil conditioning properties. Airborne sources of metal include dust emissions of air, gas or vapor streams, and fugitive emissions such as dust from storage areas or waste piles. Metals from airborne sources are released as particulates contained in the gas stream. Some metals such as arsenic, cadmium and lead can also volatilize during high temperature processing. These metals will convert to oxides and condense as fine particulates under a reducing atmosphere. Stack emissions can be distributed over a wide area by natural air currents until dry or wet precipitation mechanism remove them from the gas stream. Fugitive emissions are often distributed over a much smaller area because emissions are made near the ground. Contaminant concentrations are lower in fugitive emissions compared to the stack emissions. The type and concentration of metals emitted from both types of sources will depend on site-specific conditions. Are solid particles in smoke from fires and in other emissions from factories, chimneys are deposited on land or sea? Are solid particles in the smoke deposited on land? Most forms of the fossil fuels contain some heavy metals, include high concentration of cadmium, lead and zinc that has been found in plants and soil adjacent to smelting workers. Another major source of soil contamination is the aerial emission of lead from the combustion of petrol containing tetraethyl lead. This contributes to the content of lead in soil in urban areas and in those adjacent to the major roads. Zinc and cadmium may also be added to soil adjacent to roads, the sources being tires and lubricant oils. This is the representation of three-phase metal and the valent equilibrium in the soil, with how metals combine with the soil. M represent for the metal inert. Non-labile metal, basically labile metal. Non-labile metal may exist within the solid or the surface of solution or suspension. It is linked to the ligand, which is represented by L. Ligand may be humic, humic or fluvic acid. These three are the parts of the humus. Humus is the ongoing product of animal and plant decay present in the soil environment and concentrated on the top of most 20 centimeter layer of most mineral soil. Humus had been well explained in previous lecture. Hydrated metal ions in the clay as iron, manganese or aluminum hydroxide, surface or humus. Basically what happened, these trace metals into the soil are absorbed on the surface of colloidal particles of humus or hydroxide of iron, manganese, aluminum, aluminosilicate clay. As in the center it represents metal with the fraction of water, and ML is the metal ligand complex non-labile soil and ML with the labile soil. Humus basically contain carbon 50 to 60%, oxygen 30 to 40%, and hydrogen and nitrogen 5%. It is the having the aliphatic portion 30 to 40% and aromatic portion 20 to 40% and 10 to 20% carbohydrate. Toxicity refers to the property of a chemical to affect survival, growth and reproduction of an organism. Certain heavy metals, when their concentration increased, lead, chromium, nickel, cadmium and certain even in low concentration, mercury, arsenic, they have been reported to carcinogenic, mutagenic or to different species depending on the dose and duration of exposure, either long-term exposure or short-term exposure. Short-term exposure leading to acute effects or chronic effects, which have been already discussed in previous lecture, that toxic effects of heavy metals on the human health. Heavy metals affect both wildlife and human health. Some species are more sensitive to heavy metals than others. The mechanism by which heavy metals affect direct different organisms, tissues and systems in different organisms are very complex and for some of them are not fully explored. So heavy metals, when entered into the food chain via different routes, different anthropogenic activities, they bioaccumulate. Now what is the bioaccumulation? Bioaccumulation is basically essentially the buildup of contaminants, building up of heavy metals or pesticides or any other contaminants in the living organism. Eukaryotic organisms are often subject to bioaccumulation because they absorb contaminants from the water around faster than the bodies able to excrete them. Humans are also subject to bioaccumulation either from consuming contaminated eukaryotic organisms or from exposure to contaminants in the food, air or water. Heavy metals don't biodegrade, which means they can last for long time in our bodies. They are persistent. They don't biodegrade means don't degrade. And they are causing adverse toxic effects to the humans and organism. Now the how does bioaccumulation affect the food chain? Bioaccumulation in the food chain begins with the smallest microorganism and ends with the human. Food chain basically transfer of food in the form of chain from the smallest microorganism towards the human. Heavy metals are able to bind to the surface of microorganisms like phytoplankton in oceans and sometimes enter the cell themselves. Once they enter the cell, heavy metals can react with the chemicals released by microorganisms to digest food and undergo chemical transformation. An example is mercury becoming methyl mercury, which is especially dangerous because methyl mercury is more easily absorbed by the living organism than the mercury. Insects and zooplankton eat microorganisms, fish eat zooplankton, and eventually human order a tuna to eat at a restaurant. Tuna basically a fish that mostly human like to eat. At every point in this process, heavy metals bioaccumulate in the bodies of each living organism. By the time they get to us, we consume the heavy metals in high concentration. The increase of heavy metal concentration up the food chain is called biomagnification. Means magnification of heavy metal concentration. Most common heavy metals found in contaminated sites in order of abundance are lead, क्रोमियम, आर्सेनिक, जिंक, कैडमियम, कॉपर एंड मर्करी. दीज मेटल्स आर इम्पोर्टेंट सिंस दे आर कैपेबल ऑफ डिक्रीजिंग क्रॉप प्रोडक्शन ड्यू टू रिस्क ऑफ बायो एक्युमुलेशन एंड बायो मैग्निफिकेशन इन द फूड चेन. देर आर आल्सो द रिस्क ऑफ सुपरफिशियल एंड ग्राउंड वाटर कंटामिनेशन. नॉलेज ऑफ द बेसिक केमिस्ट्री, इन्वायरमेंटल एंड एसोसिएटेड health effects of these heavy metals is necessary in understanding their association, bioavailability and remedial options. The fate and transport of heavy metals in the soil depends on the chemical form and speciation of heavy metals. Once in the soil, these heavy metals are absorbed by the initial fast reaction that takes place in minutes or hours, followed by slow adsorption reaction that in the days or in the years, and are redistributed into different chemical forms with varying bioavailability, mobility and toxicity. The distribution is believed to control by the reaction of heavy metals in soil, such as mineral precipitation, dissolution, ion exchange, adsorption, desorption, aqueous complexation, biological immobilization, mobilization and plant uptake. Heavy metal may enter the body of the organism directly from abiotic environment, that is water sediments and soil, or may enter the organism body from its food prey, as you see in this diagram. For example, heavy metals may enter the fish body directly from water or sediment through the fish gills, skin, or from the fish food prey through its alimentary canal. The concentration of heavy metal may increase or decrease along successive trophic levels in a food chain. The retention of heavy metals in the body of an organism depends on many factors, such as speciation of metal concerned and physiological mechanism developed by the organism for the regulation. Homeostasis and detoxification of the heavy metals. Methylated form of heavy metals such as mercury are accumulated in the biota to a greater extent and therefore biomagnified in the food chain due to their lipophilicity. Certain plants have the ability to thrive on metal rich habitats are called metallophytes. These special plants have developed special mechanism for coping with the higher heavy metal concentration in the soil and are divided into three categories: excluder indicators and hyper accumulators. Certain terms are used to describe the trophic transfer of heavy metals as represented in this picture. The soil to plant transfer of heavy metal is very important step in trophic transfer of such metals in the food chain. These metals are taken up by the plants from the polluted soil and transferred to the herbivorous animals along the food chain. Regarding contamination of heavy human food chain, contamination of crops such as cereals and vegetables is a very serious issue. Hence, the heavy metal transferred through the food chain to the humans and organisms and causing the toxicity. The specific type of metal contamination found in contaminated soil is directly related to operation that occurred at the site. The range of contaminated concentration and the physical and chemical forms of contaminants will depend on activities and disposal pattern for contaminated waste on the site. Soil may contain metals in the solid, gaseous or liquid phases, and these may complicate analysis and interpretation of the reported results. Most common method for determining the concentration of metals contaminant in soil via total elemental analysis. The level of metal contamination determined by this method is expressed as milligram metal per kilogram soil. These analysis doesn't specify requirements for the moisture content of the soil and may include soil water. दिस मेजरमेंट मे आल्सो बी रिपोर्टेड ऑन ए ड्राई सॉइल बेसिस. The level of contamination may be reported as leachable metal as determined by leach tests such as toxicity characteristic leaching procedure known as TCLP or the synthetic precipitation leaching procedure known as SPLP test. These procedures measure the concentration of metal in leachate form soil contacted with an acetic acid solution or dilute solution of sulfuric acid and nitric acid. Acetic acid solution is used in case of toxicity characteristic leaching procedure, and sulfuric acid and nitric acid is used in procedure of synthetic precipitation leaching procedure. In this case, metal contamination is expressed in milligram per liter of the leachable metal. The protection and restoration of soil ecosystem contaminated by heavy metals require their characterization and remediation. Contemporary legislation respiring environmental protection and public health at both national and international level are based on data that characterize chemical properties of environmental phenomena, especially those that reside in our food chain. While soil characterization would provide an insight into heavy metal speciation and bioavailability at remediation of heavy metal contaminated soil, immobilization, soil washing, phytoremediation techniques are listed among the best demonstrated available technologies for remediation of heavy metal contaminated sites. In most developing countries, these are yet to become commercially available technologies due to inadequate awareness of their advantage and principle of operation. All these technologies as phytoremediation, remediation of heavy metals, phytofiltration will be discussed in the next lecture.